A tremendous fire. The parachute burns away. Salisbury, he's protected now. He's in front of that fire, but it still burns at the back of Salisbury's car as he slides the machine to a stop. And Jeb Allen has won the championship.
Quarters in session. A verdict is in. One of the youngest professional drag racers, former Summer Nationals champ, and certainly one of the really strong runners here at this World Championship race.
The first race car I ever drove was a top fuel dragster. It was a front engine car. My dad said, I'm not going to build a rear engine car unless you can prove to me that you can drive this thing. And Tom McEwen and Don Perdomo signed my driver's license.
72 at the age of 24. Gary Beck sitting, watching as Jeb Allen saving the parts for another day because there'll be another race. And Jeb Allen, the winner. Look at him applauding as the car sort of guides itself down the racetrack. And in elated, Jeb Allen just applauding himself and dejection on the face of Gary Beck.
Maybe that big of a deal so earlier in your career, did that help or hurt you? Well, that definitely helped me. I couldn't have continued to do it because my dad was going to quit, and the money part of it was, we weren't that well off, like some of the people that do it. 70% of the people we raced against were hobbyists. This was their flying in their Learjets or their jets, and we'd race against them. And outperform them, but the part that got to me the most was being able to be the guy out there with Levi's on, not having all of this money besides every dime I earned at the racetrack to keep my car running. I took my hands and put over my face, and luckily I had all third-degree burns down through here. I have skin grafts. I spent a month and a half in the hospital with skin grafts on my hands, but I saved my face by just, I said, I don't want to watch no more of this. I had enough. But that was a tough time. People like Pennzoil and Revell and Dodge all come together and helped me get back into it again.
What's going on in the Lucille Lee pit area? It's Jeb Allen's car, and obviously the engine is out of the car, and there it is on the hook. That is Mark Danicus, the owner of Lucille Lee's car, and that is the engine that Jeb Allen said was no good. And that's Lucille Lee's car, and it looks like they're getting ready to drop Jeb Allen's engine in the car.
Hi, Shirley Muldany. Have you seen what's going on down the road here?
I know exactly what's going on. They are taking the motor out of Jeb's car, right? The motor that would not run the round he had to race Lucille, and they're putting it in Lucille's car. So it's another buy.
No one else in that pit area came up to me and offered me a motor. I hadn't raced Mark Danicus, Lucille Lee, for like a year and a half. And Mark said, I'll lend you the motor, but you can't race me with my own motor. And I said, okay, you got a deal. It just started fading and costing more money, and the other racers had more assets than we did, and I just started to lose my drive and determination because I knew that I couldn't get. I was also pursuing other sponsorships and trying to get the big sponsorships, and part of my, it's not a secret that I'm a recovering alcoholic, and I couldn't get these sponsorships because I think the people would stand back. You're the last one to know when you're a drug addict or an alcoholic. You're the last one to know. I'm going to become the best or I'm going to go broke doing it. Well, I won 3 world championships and I went broke.